Yeah, good morning students. Today we are learning the next practical of physics class 12. The name of the practical is to determine resistance per centimeter of a given wire. Resistance per centimeter means resistivity of a given wire by plotting the graph of potential difference versus the current. As we have already learned in 10th standard about this relationship between voltage, that is potential difference, and the current. Just check it out in the theory. You must have seen this formula before. This is simply the Ohm's law. That is, voltage is directly proportional to current. Normally we say that as long as physical state of conductor remains constant, the potential difference applied across that conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing through it. So we know that there is a constant quantity between, as Ohm said, and that is what resistance. So here we are having one wire, okay, having the length 1 meter, and that particular wire having a certain resistance that we are going to measure with this experiment. And we are measuring, okay, the wire and its resistance per centimeter. As you can check it out over here, this is what the wire of 1 meter, right? And this particular 1 meter wire has a certain resistance that we are calculating, and we will calculate per centimeter resistance of the same wire. Can check it out the circuit diagram, that the battery connection, positive terminal of the battery is connected to ammeter, that ammeter is connected in series with the battery. Now we are having this particular wire, just now I have shown you, this is what voltmeter which we have connected in a parallel position of the wire, and we have connected the rheostat, right? This is a variable terminal of rheostat which is used to change the value of voltage, and this is fixed terminal of resistance, rheostat connected to the battery through the key. You can check it out the real component appearance. This is the battery, ammeter, voltmeter. This is our wire, whichever resistance we are measuring per centimeter. This is rheostat, and this is the key which is connected again to the battery. Now you can check it out the circuit diagram. As per the circuit diagram, this positive of the battery is connected to the positive of ammeter, then negative of ammeter is connected to the positive of the voltmeter. Now across voltmeter we have connected this wire which is of resistance wire, then negative of the voltmeter is connected to the one terminal of rheostat. As you can check, this is one terminal. The variable terminal of rheostat is connected to the key, one terminal of key, and the other terminal is connected to the negative of the battery. So this is what the complete circuit as shown in figure. Now let's discuss about first observations of this circuit. That is length of the resistance wire. Just now I have told you that is of what? 1 meter. Next, range. Range of the given voltmeter, ammeter. We can check it out here. That ammeter is of 5 ampere. So we can write it is of 5. Here it is of what? 5 ampere. Right? Range of the given voltmeter. You can check it out. The range of given voltmeter is a 10 volt. So we have to write over here 10 volt. Now least count of ammeter, you know that how to count the least count, how to find the least count. You can check it out that first ammeter. So in this case 0 to 1 there are 10 lines. So the least count is 0.1 ampere. So we have to write over here 0.1 ampere. And the least count of voltmeter, can check it out, least count of voltmeter, there are 10 lines in between 0 and 2, so therefore each line indicates 0.2 volt. So we will write 0.2 volt least count. Now there is no error, you can check it out in this one, that this pointer is exactly on 0 and this pointer is also exactly on 0. So that's why we are writing that there is no error and there is no correction. Now you can check the observation table. It's the same normal observation table as we have learned in Ohm's law. It's an ammeter reading. First we have to write the ammeter reading, that is the current meter, and this is of voltmeter reading, we have to write voltmeter. Now we will not write anything over here, that means same value we will write because the value of C1, C2 both are say 0, right? So this value we will write as it is over here, this value we will write as it is over here, and we will divide, we will get the value of resistance. For example, suppose we have switched on this connection. And we can check it out that first we will keep the voltage on first line. So that first line means one line indicates 0.2 volt. So I'm just adjusting the rheostat in a such a way that this rheostat, this voltmeter shows the reading of one line ahead, that is of 0.2 volt. Can check it out, there is a one line ahead, so of 0.2 volt. So I'm writing over here that it is of 0.2 volt. Now for that, what is the ammeter shows the reading? Can check it out, what is the reading showing by ammeter? How many lines ahead? It's of again one line ahead. So that's why its value is 0.1 ampere. Right? In this same manner, if we change the value of voltage, can check it out together here. If we change the value of voltage, okay, we will get that the different readings of ammeter. Right? This is the maximum value. Again, we can change the value in this manner. Right? So these different values will get it over here of different values of ammeter and the voltmeter, and we will get the common value of the resistance. So whichever value we'll get, that PDF form I'll just send it to you. Whichever values we will get over here, we'll take mean value of that. That is the total resistance of this wire. Total resistance of this wire. And then whatever this is of 100 centimeter wire, so we'll just divide it by 100, we'll get the total resistance per centimeter. Now as you have learned in Ohm's law, that same calculations we are learning in a different way, that is of what? By using the graph, that tan theta is equal to AB upon CB, that's I upon V. So we'll use cot theta. Can check it out, the graph over here, right? So this graph is what? Cot of this angle. Now we are measuring the value of R with the help of graph also, but not only by using the slope, but by using the value of angle. So this particular graph I'll draw and I'll send it in that PDF form, so that you'll come to know how to do the calculation of this R with the help of the theta, and how can we write the result, that is the resistance per centimeter of the wire, by dividing 100, and we have to verify that voltage versus current law, that is Ohm's law. Thank you so much.